Hey guys, Chris here. So I want to share a little bit about this video. It's about our RV electrical system and what we have done. We've lived for 2.5 years full-time on our truck camper, and in the course of time, we've seen some things we wanted to change. So this is our interpretation of how an RV electrical system can be better optimized to do what you need to do when you're living on the road. I wanted to share a little bit before you watch this video about why we're doing what we're doing and what we are actually doing. So you can skip ahead. I put the timeline in the description below. So if you wanted to skip to a particular section and see what we did or why we did it or how we did it, you can go ahead and do that. Or if you want to watch this whole thing through, you will see how we took what worked for us, but not very well, into what we believe is going to be 100% perfect efficiency for what we need to do within the tight budget that we had. All the parts that you'll see cost us under $750. So you can do this. I didn't die doing this. Enjoy watching. I am going to give a disclaimer right now, call it an affiliate disclaimer. We use all Renogy products. They're not paying us to say this. We are affiliates for them and we can give you a discount if you use the link below. But we use Renogy products because we love them. It's as literal plug and play as possible in most situations. We love the tech support. In fact, as I was planning out all the things that we had to do, I'm not an electrician. I've learned all of this by studying, by YouTube videos, by friends, and by reaching out directly to the tech team at Renogy and saying, hey, can I do it this way? Or should I do it that way? And having somebody say, no, you got to think about it this way or that way. So we love the technical support. Of course, we love the products. And so you will see us using all Renogy products. I want to put that disclaimer there because we don't want to be misleading about our relationship with Renogy. We do love Renogy, and that's why we personally purchased all of our products, and we reached out to them and said, can we offer a discount to other people if they like what we like? With today's project, we're going to be switching out our batteries, putting in AGM batteries instead of the lead acid batteries that we currently have. These are more durable and they're maintenance free. We're upgrading from a 600 watt inverter to a 1000 watt inverter. And we're also going to be switching out our PWM solar controller for an MPPT controller. That's going to provide us lots of efficiency. We're going to be able to trust our batteries to give us all the energy that we need as we continue to live and work full-time out of our truck camper. So to get started today, we're going to take our camper off of our truck. And when we do that, I'll show you our unique setup is that we've got one battery on our truck and we've got one battery on our camper. We connect them in parallel through a short run of about 4 or 5 feet, but that's been, I would say, a total pain in the butt because of what we'll show you. In order to take the camper off the truck, it's not as simple as just lifting up the camper and driving out. We've got to disconnect the batteries. So we're going to go and do that and show you how that works, and then show you the space that we're going to clear up and on the truck and in the camper, and we'll show you the space that we're going to take for the new batteries. We're going to put these in a nice storage area that will be dedicated just for the batteries and the inverter and all the associated wiring. Everything will be nice and neat, connected just in this one space in the camper, so we won't have all of these crazy wires going around like we currently do. So with our current setup, we have our camper battery, which came standard with our Lance, and then we wanted a second battery when we set out, so the only place we could store one is actually by mounting it on our truck. And so we've got this battery here and this battery there, and we're running wires to connect the two in parallel. While this worked great for us, it wasn't an ideal setup, and now that we have the ability to upgrade and modify our system, we want to make it as convenient as possible for us. So we're going to get rid of this battery being here, we're going to get rid of this battery being here, and we're going to move them inside to a storage compartment where we'll have both of our new AGM batteries together. We're going to take the wiring off this battery so that the truck can move out underneath the camper and the wires are going to be hanging there. We are currently plugged into shore power, so before we do any work, electrical speaking, we're going to make sure that our shore power is unplugged. And we're also going to make sure that all of our batteries are disconnected from the wiring inside the camper. So just to show you all that right now, This is the wiring that goes into our inverter. And then we've got the wiring between the two batteries. And up here is the wires that run into the camper. So we'll be coming back to this in just a moment once we get the camper off the truck. Now that the camper's off the truck, this is the mess that we're dealing with. These are the two wires that were connecting the two batteries in parallel. This is our solar input, the positive, I believe. And then we had the second set of wires right here is our inverter, which is right there on the other side inside our camper. So we had all that going on. And this is where we plug into our truck. So this will stay. We'll be keeping this one, but all this is going away. The rest of it is going to go away. We're going to move all the wires inside and make it nice and neat and tight. Looking at our camper battery compartment, it's a cluster too. You can see all these wires going all over the place. They need to be there, but we're going to clean this up when we move the battery. This battery is coming out. This strap right here did very little, if anything. We're getting rid of this battery. We're getting rid of this area where we're storing batteries. This will turn into some cool storage for us, Lindsay's horse gear and her dirty horse poop boots. And we're gonna get rid of all this. So we'll get on to that now. This is the house positive. This is the solar positive. So this one down here was the solar negative. And then this is the positive to connect our two batteries in parallel. So I'm gonna wrap these just because it's a habit of mine to wrap them in electrical tape, and then we'll pull the battery out and take you inside and show you where the new batteries are gonna be going. Inside our bathroom is the access door to get into where all the wires come in from our camper box, our camper battery box. And so I'm gonna back out of the way. But you can see these were just plugged into the battery. They run in here with a whole bunch of other wires. So what we're going to do is we're going to get all this out of the battery box, and we're going to run these wires. Like, this is the house positive, this one right here. Going to have to run it back through the camper all the way around to the new place where we're putting our batteries, which means we're going to be taking some appliances out. But no worries, everything in a camper was put in a camper, and everything can come out and go back in. It's just a matter of figuring out what to unscrew and unbolt and so forth. So we're gonna do that in ours. That'll be the next step for us, is running these wires from the old battery box all the way to where we're gonna put the new storage. So our RV power center is actually underneath our sink. You can see it is a complicated swirl of wires. Yours probably looks about the same. All the wires from the battery ran from here behind our stove, behind our heater, behind our shower bathroom, and we now have to run those wires back through to here, and then we're going to run them behind me. Got to take this off. So there's a cavity that runs along here, and we're going to run the new wires all the way around through this compartment and down into where the batteries will be stored in here. In theory, it should not be too difficult. in reality, it's gonna be a crazy mess. This bundle of wires right here is what I need to pull from behind our oven and pull the bundle back around through here. Got these wires. These are the four that I need. I got them as far back as behind the oven. Now I gotta keep moving them around the corner here. That's gonna be a pain in the butt, because this part was. So now they're going behind the hot water heater and they're taped into a bigger bundle. All I need are these four, but there's a bundle of like, I don't know, maybe 12 wires that go to our tail lights and all the other stuff that's in the back. And so I've got to keep these four out of the bundles, and it's been not so easy.
Chris just farted, and I have to stand here and sniff it while I film.
It's part of the job, babe.
No.
I had four wires, and I'm down to one, and I got this one moving. So what that means is that I'm going to have all of my bundle through here, and these are my three battery wires over here. So I'm just going to have a short run, and I actually have way too much wire to tuck in to the battery compartment. So I just keep on pulling on this guy, like so. Wire down, tuck it underneath there. So, and now I got my solar, positive and negative, right there. And then we've got our battery positive and negative right there. This is a big victory. Big victory. Okay. So what I got to do now is I'm going to run these wires through and get them ready to put them in this little special place for the batteries. And then I can put that, close that lid back on. And then it's just a matter of building out the battery storage and the inverter and hooking everything up. This now is gonna come into here.
The fridge cabinet.
I'm gonna start with the blue and white solar. Bring it on up into here like so. Because we have too much wire, I'm not going to run it anymore, because I'm going to tuck the extra in with the water. This little compartment in here will hold it nice out of the way, so only then enough wire will go in there, because remember, we're trying to make things simpler and clean. So the mess will be buried underneath there, which is kind of like when you're a kid and you're supposed to sweep the floor.
And you just sweep it under the rug.
Sweep it under the rug. In our case, we're gonna sweep it under our step, more or less. Okay, so that part's done. We know we got the wires all the way back here. We know everything's gonna hook up fine. So now it's a matter of building the battery space out, which I think I've tried to do three times already. We're gonna build it out the way we want it now. We're gonna fit the inverter in there. Then we're gonna plug everything in and cross our fingers and pray that it all works. Where we're putting our batteries is going to be underneath the bench in our salon, which means I'm going to have to do some surgery to our bench so I can have access to it from the top. This is hollow. So I'm going to cut some holes. Now I'm going to move the batteries in, and I'm going to build a frame for the batteries to hold them in place. It's all going to be wood, and that'll make it lightweight. It will be secure, and I do not expect anything to move around with these batteries. They are AGM, so they can rumble a little bit, but I don't want them hopping around like our other batteries did. So building the frame for the batteries, it's really simple. We're going to use 2x4, and we're going to cut it up into pieces that will fit around the batteries and hold them in place. We're into day two of this project. Spent 10 hours working on it yesterday and it carried over, which means I did some things wrong, some things didn't go as planned, and we had some surprises. So I've spent a lot of time trying to figure everything out. I'm gonna catch you up on where we are, and then today we're gonna wrap it up. Don't have any more time. So I think I got it all figured out. One of our biggest problems was getting behind the stove and pulling our wires all the way through. Right here to come to our battery compartment down there. I dig back there and fortunately I have long arms, and we threaded some things using coat hanger and got all the wires where they needed to go. But that took a lot more time than what we actually expected to be able to get it all set up. Then I was able to build our little box for our inverter. It's very simple. It's made out of 2x4s. And what's going to happen is this is going to sit between the two batteries. And we're going to mount the inverter on it. Just like this. Another thing I did yesterday was I mounted the stud junction block pair, the positive and the negative. So we're going to pull wire off our battery and go to that junction block. And then from there, we're going to distribute the power and the grounds separately. That'll clean up our batteries a lot. So we'll only have one positive and one negative connection coming off of the battery. And that will go to the junction block. And then from there, everything else related to power will tie in. Then the last thing that I did was I went ahead and made all the wire runs that I was going to need, and put the terminals on. These are out of 4-gauge for everything that's going to be connected to the battery or the inverter. And with the inverter, we do have 30-amp fuse on there. So now I'm ready to put everything together, plug it in, and hopefully have it work. Moment of truth. I got everything wired up. I'll show you the diagrams for how we wired everything together. Basically the same wiring as it was before. I just moved the batteries and the inverter and I moved everything. So it's the same wiring, but I will show you those diagrams. And I've got one switch that controls the house power. So I'm gonna unplug the switch real quick, see what happens. We should have lights and the radio should turn on. Here's the switch. Hey. We got lights. The radio turned on.
Thursday, we'll see our temperatures make a climb, upper 80s, even some low 90s in our inland areas. Factor in the humidity, and it's going to feel like the upper 90s.
So far, so good. I'm going to go ahead and plug in the battery monitor now. I've got it all wired. I just have to literally just plug it in. And when I do that, we'll see if we're able to read the battery state of charge. And the monitor is a little fidgety right now. Still got to work on some of the telling it what's full state of charge. But it is accurate in the amperage. We're drawing 1 amp because I've got a couple lights on. Okay, so where we are now, we've got the batteries in their new location. We've got the inverter in its new location. We have the batteries in the inverter hooked up together. They're also hooked up to the power center of our camper. So we've got the bulk of the work done. What we have left to do is we need to switch out our controller and get rid of our PWM controller for our new fancy MPPT controller. It is a bit bigger, and we're going to try to fit it in the same spot. Just from the sake of wiring, so I don't have to move things around and run wires even more. But we're going to check that out, make sure it fits nice and snug and safely. And that's the next step of what we need to do. At that point, I'll be able to plug everything in to the controller. So we'll have the battery plugged in, and then we'll plug in our solar. And we'll actually be able to test out to make sure everything is working correctly. Now that I have the controller mounted, it's time to go ahead and wire it up. So we've got the solar panels that'll come into the controller, and we've got the battery that will be feeding out of the controller. Important thing to note is that you always want to make sure that your battery is plugged in first before you plug in the solar panels into the controller. So here's our setup. Batteries, solar. So we're going to plug these in first, and then we'll plug in our solar, and that should run power all the way to our batteries. And here's the gauge, which should be able to tell us right away that we're charging. Right now we're fully charged, and with the lights on, we're drawing 0.35 amps, give or take, which is pretty awesome. Well, we have solar hooked up, so that's good. Everything is set up from our solar panels to our batteries. Batteries are now inside the camper. This job is complete. For all intents and purposes, I've got to clean up and get everything put back together. But we have now officially become 100% Renogy products inside our camper. Got 3 100-watt solar panels. We have 2 100-amp-hour AGM batteries. We have 1,000 watt inverter, and we have the 40 amp MPPT controller. All that's hooked up together. So we have set up our camper 100% with Renogy products. And we will, of course, let you know how that goes, if we have any issues down the road, how well those issues are resolved. But we don't foresee having very many problems. This was not easy, but it's definitely doable. I'm not an electrician or an expert in RVs, but I am learning. And so if I can learn and figure out how to do this, you can as well. Hopefully this video has helped you to this point. And if you haven't already done so, please like our channel. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video, and leave a friendly comment, positive. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope it helps you out. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments or send us an email. We'll catch you later.